Time now to connect with Kapil Mehan, Managing Director with Coromandel International. Morning, Kapil. Thank you for joining us. Kapil, for the quarter gone by, Coromandel International has reported disappointing set of numbers. So why were your profits down for the quarter gone by, and what hit you the hardest? Higher phosphate prices, currency fluctuation, or low demand?
I think you should see the numbers before exceptional items. You know, our sales is up by almost 24-25%. Our EBITDA is also up, and if we account for the composition of our sales, where a lot of imported fertilizers got sold during this quarter, so operationally this quarter has been better than quarter last year. Yes, if you compare with September quarter, then there is a decline, but I think we have to be careful in making these comparisons, because we are in the business of agriculture, and it is a seasonal business, so it will depend on the cropping patterns and stuff like that. So right way to look at would be really to look at on a annualized basis, past 12 months, and I think on that account, operationally, this year has been better than last year.
Kapil, hi, morning. How has been the volume growth of DAP as well as MOP, and do you foresee a demand decline going forward?
I think we will see some demand compression taking place over the next one or two quarters, but that would be more to do with inventory levels getting corrected rather than any fundamental erosion of demand. We are also seeing that international prices have started softening, and that would put us in a better position to deal with these situations, and we don't see that prices in the next one or two quarters would go up as far as selling price to farmer is concerned. On the contrary, there are reports in the press of government wanting to reduce its subsidy. Given the price movements in the international market, I think that should be feasible, and that would be possible, as well as a small correction in the selling prices. So we don't think that demand destruction will happen because of prices.
Kapil, a word on the non-subsidy business and how things have shaped up in that vertical for Coromandel International for the quarter gone by.
That has continued to grow. Our specialty nutrients business, our compost business has done well. Our retail business has done well. Only agrochemicals, there is a small dip in terms of top line, primarily because of ban on endosulfan, which was announced by Supreme Court sometime in May of last year, as well as the seasonal factors have not been very helpful during October-December quarter, with northeast monsoons having been much below normal, as well as acreages of some crops having dipped. So despite that, I think our non-subsidy, non-fertilizer portfolio continues to do well, and giving us a healthy EBITDA level as compared to our core fertilizer business.